Nisles Golf Club in Kent is playing host to the 2016 Sir Henry Cooper Junior Masters. Some of the best young golfers in Britain and Ireland and from around Europe competing for what's become one of the most sought-after prizes in the junior game. Started 18 years ago, the Junior Masters gives young players a chance to get a taste of what it's like to play in a top tour event. And it's been a rite of passage now for many European tour professionals. They'll all remember their first taste of this tournament, the legacy of the late great British heavyweight boxing champion, Sir Henry himself.
He was president of our club, and I got to know him as captain, and we became good friends. And the first year I asked him if he would come along and present the prizes. Yeah, mate, yeah, that's good, you know. And then the next year I asked him if he'd be the patron.
Dad was always into his sport, loved his boxing, and when he retired, he needed a sport to take over from, you know, not being in the gym. And golf was that substitute, and he loved playing golf. That was his second love. So, and then to see youngsters coming through, and he thought it was, you know, just fantastic. There's an opportunity for these guys to shine. So, you know, so for his love of golf and seeing these youngsters doing what they were doing, that's why he was motivated by it.
Plenty of European Tour winners amongst the players who've competed in the Sir Henry Cooper Junior Masters, and they include this year's BMW PGA champion Chris Wood. Ollie Fisher competed here in 2003.
First year I turned up, I was lucky enough to be playing with Henry himself, so, or Sir Henry himself, and you know, my granddad comes to watch that day too, and my granddad's a fruit and veg wholesaler as well by trade, and Sir Henry was a market trader as well, like, you know, as well as working on his boxing, you know, he'd done that before then as well, so, you know, it was great. My granddad could ride around with him, and we had a really, really fun day.
I know I love, back in the days, I love to play those junior events and you know, compete with the best in Europe, under 18, and I always enjoyed it, and it was good fun to win one or two of those events.
As far as the event goes, you know, they've supported me when I was younger with a bursary and stuff to help me through my junior golf, and, you know, I think from what I hear, the tournament's gone from strength to strength over the years too. They get a lot more of an international field, and you know, it looks it's very positive.
An all-star cast came to Nisles for the celebrity pro-am. Lots of money raised for some great charities, and a great opportunity for these youngsters to feel what it's like to be a tour pro.
The aim today is to raise money to help some of the young players, you know, prepare properly for their tournament, you know, perhaps stay in a hotel, go there the night before, etc. So that's the main reason. And my brother, obviously, my older brother Billy, who's a patron of the Teenage Cancer Trust, so and that's another part of the day for us.
With me, it's all about teenagers. We started the Teenage Cancer Trust many years ago, along with my band that I managed, The Who, and it was a natural partnership to come and try and do something with the Henry Cooper Foundation. It's a perfect match, perfect fit for me.
Sir Henry Cooper, you know, huge respect for Henry, you know, and what he did. And I think to carry on his name and have it associated with the development of young talent, young golfers especially, is fantastic, because he loved his golf. And so, yeah, well, I was invited to come. I kind of get invited to a lot of golf games, but some are in Kinson, yeah, definitely go to that one. So it's great to be here today, because I think it just ticks all the right boxes, especially the helping develop young boys and girls in their ability to play golf.
It's just brilliant to be part of it, because if you think about today, we're raising money for the Teenage Cancer Trust, but also raising money to help young golfers get into the game, because it's a hugely expensive game.
I think you speak to most people, someone's been affected by cancer. My dad died of cancer at a pretty early age. Some charity events just tick all the boxes, and this is right at the top of the list.
Remember, we've got both a girls and a boys competition coming up, and a good omen for Harvey Byers, the winner of the individual prize in the Pro-Am, and the team prize picked up by Guy Fletcher's team. He was a former keyboard man for Dire Straits. And a charity auction raised, by the way, over £20,000 for the Teenage Cancer Trust and the Sir Henry Cooper Junior Masters Trust as well, two charities to benefit from this wonderful week, and what an opportunity for these youngsters, who remember are competing over four rounds of stroke play here at Nisles.
It's been advertised all over the world, and it really does attract the big field. Past winners, past players really are on tour now, so that just brings people here, and a victory would do their careers much good.
I got drawn to it because everybody said how good the tournament was run. You know, I played the pro-am yesterday and it was good fun, and you know, it's just kind of the most kind of realistic European tour event a junior can have, really, to be fair.
My coach, he gave me some information on the tournament, and he told me that it's a good experience for me since there are many top players playing in the tournament. So we just got together and this made all the plans and the arrangements. I stayed with him to come over here to play in this tournament.
Well, I played in it last year and I quite like the set out of the tournament and the course. I quite like the course, and it's the like Sir Henry Cooper, so it's quite like an honour to play in this again for the second time.
There are so many volunteers to make the tournament possible. I mean, live scoring and all the four caddies and all the people are so friendly here. It's just great.
Well, it really does have a tour feel to it. They play over four rounds, one each on Friday and Saturday. Then there's a cut, and those who make it through play two rounds on Sunday as well. Reflecting the European nature of this competition, Chiara Tambellini over from Switzerland shot a 77 on the opening day. That's five over par. Like Nathan Longley, she was out early, and Nathan shot a 68, four under.
I played nicely. I got pretty lucky with the weather, I think, because the weather, it didn't look good, so it was nice to only have a little bit of rain, not too much rain. So, yeah, so I was pretty pleased with it. I played nicely.
Well, Nathan and Chiara are lucky to get out early because we had some heavy rainfall late on Friday, and the first round had to be carried over to be completed on Saturday. And with two rounds to be played on Sunday, the organisers did a great job to get things back on track on Saturday. The course took on quite a bit of water, but it didn't seem to affect Harry Goddard, who set the early pace, the first round leader after an opening day 66.
I was out last group yesterday, so I only managed to get five holes in. I was four under for those five, so pretty decent. But yeah, I mean, the momentum, I thought it might have got slashed a bit, but I went out strong again today. So, I mean, my first, four holes, I was another three under. So, I mean, got out to a good start and then just carried it on, really.
So everything back on track for the two rounds on Sunday, and leading the girls' competition, Annabelle Fuller, who shot a third round 67 Sunday morning to lie at six under, a comfortable leader. This is Connor Richards, who made a birdie at the seventh hole Sunday morning, and he finished at four under through three rounds. Charlie Strickland, lovely swing. Birdies for him at the 7th, 8th and 9th. And he started the final round at 5 under par. Christian Donaldson did make a bogey at the 8th, which could have tied the lead. As it is, he starts one behind. Still very much in contention, but the youngster leading the way, Michael Gilbert. A birdie at the 9th for him, as he set the three-round target at 7 under par.
This morning it was actually quite windy, and a few of the holes played really long, like 18. But then on the back nine, sort of, it's more tree-lined, so you can get away with that. And then sort of the greens, they're really quick this morning. I think they said it was 12 and a half on the stimp or something. And yeah, the course is just really nice. Playing firm, but scoreable.
Two rounds in the 60s have taken Michael Gilbert to the top. He is one ahead of Christian Donaldson and two clear of Charlie Strickland and Callum Farr. The final round of the Sir Henry Cooper Junior Masters from Nisles Golf Club when we come back. The 2016 Sir Henry Cooper Junior Masters taking place at Nisles Golf Club. It's been 5 years since the sad passing of the great man himself, but what a legacy he has left to the game of golf with this Masters competition. And Gary Alice, with me, Dominic Hollier, watching the final day. Nothing happens without all these volunteers.
It doesn't, Dominic, though. The help that they give to these young players, making sure scorecards are right, helping them, interacting with them, it really, without them, the event couldn't happen.
So an exciting final day in prospect. And Annabelle Fuller leads the girls' competition by some distance. And Michael Gilbert is ahead in the boys' competition, but only by a shot. This is Chiara Tambellini over from Switzerland. Very much an international tournament this is becoming, Gary.
Yes, there are players from all around Europe, and it is the closest event to a proper professional event, playing four rounds.
And she looks like she's got a very tidy putting stroke. So Michael Gilbert getting underway, nervous moments no doubt.
Nice looking swing though there, good balance, keeping himself well under control.
15 years of age, plus one handicap.
It is fantastic that she'd get such a low handicap at such a young age.
So many good youngsters about. And what about Annabelle?
Yes, from the Roehampton Golf Club. Just outside of London. Good contact there. A little bit too much spin. Ball back to the edge of the green. But very, very good shot.
Looks like a prospect. Only 14 years of age. Runner-up in the Scottish Under-18 Girls Championship already this year. Back to Gilbert in the boys' competition.
Short iron from the middle of the fairway. Yeah, very nice, nice result. Steady the nerves, on his way.
Breezy conditions out there today, so by no means easy, but the course in wonderful condition. Look at these putting surfaces. Fuller for birdie.
Yeah, the ball ran absolutely superbly across the green. They've worked so hard to get these at a speed, and again, for a lot of the youngsters, these may be as quick as some of the greens they've ever played.
And that's despite all the rain we had yesterday as well. Gilbert with a birdie putt, a chance to settle the nerves.
Yep, very steady, good stroke. Oh, look at that. I mean, it was hardly running at any pace for it to catch the lip and spin out there. Unlucky.
So he stays at 7 under. A couple of terrific rounds, 2 and 3, 67, 69. Took him to the top of the leaderboard through the first three rounds.
Now Goddard, second hole. Cries of four to the right. That's all right, it's only just on the fringe.
Yeah, wasn't that wide, was it? Can see that there is some thick rough about in places here, so you've certainly got to keep out of that.
Yes, it's one of those things this year with the wet spring, lots of thick grass as we watch Farr.
Beautiful tempo to the swing of Callum Farr there.
It was a lovely rhythm, and right over the top of the flag to 15 feet.
And if you're wondering why Callum Farr's playing behind Michael Gilbert, that's because they played two rounds today and there was no redraw between the two rounds.
Back to Annabelle Fuller. Nice to see almost a traditional chip there. She tried to land it on the edge of the fringe and just let it ease out. Very nice touch. That's good.
Yeah, so often today all the young players follow the tour professionals and they have these very lofted wedges, throwing it through the air. This is Donaldson. Come on down.
Yeah, you're right. They do. They tend to go for these lob wedges and chuck it in the air, whereas actually, never forget, the ball's round, it will roll.
And nicely rolled there as well for Annabelle Fuller. Par putt there. Long way ahead in this girls' competition. so doesn't need to do too much over the final round. Back to Callum Farr at the first for birdie.
Oh, beautifully done. Just the whisker of break off the left there, and the pace was absolutely perfect as it turned in. Very, very good shot.
And Christian Donaldson now, just tidying up for par. No problem at all. So Gilbert one ahead of Donaldson and Farr, and then it's Strickland and Richards both at four under.
Lovely to see so many people out supporting, parents and spectators and everything on this lovely day.
Now our leader potentially in a spot of bother here. Up and over the trees. Has he got the distance right? Well, it wasn't too bad. Leave himself an uphill putt.
Yeah, a chance. As we cross again to Annabelle Fuller. Got a good swing. All part of the England squad.
Yeah, part of three teams they've sent here this week. Her sister Sam is also part of the England setup. So a golfing family.
Always nice when they can spur each other on as we watch Gilbert putting from the fringe and rolling it very nicely into the hole.
Well, that's important stuff from Michael Gilbert, who plays his golf out of Chelmsford Golf Club.
A nice face and lovely smile.
Back to Annabelle. Fourth shot at the par five, fourth hole. Again, it's that low chip and run.
And it's well judged. This is good from young player to get the ball up within 4 feet like that. It's a good shot, good contact.
Yeah, they must be very proud of her down at Roehampton Golf Club. Now, a similar spot to where we just saw Gilbert. This is Longley.
And that really is a splendid shot up and over from under there where he got not able to see anything and sets himself up there only 3 feet away from the hole.
Yeah, well done, Nathan, who plays his golf down in Worthing. He's got Marco Penge on the bag today, last year's Sir Henry Cooper Masters champion.
As we watch Annabelle Fuller trying to convert from her chip from the edge, and no trouble at all for the young lady.
So Longley, after that terrific approach, takes advantage as well. And a good bounce back. Made a triple bogey seven at the opening hole. Needs to kick on now if he is going to contend for this prestigious title. Jack Cope, second shot into the fourth.
Big hit, launches it high into the air. Little bit of draw. Got a nice little skip forward there, Nomit.
Super stuff, wasn't it? Girls incidentally playing ahead of the boys today. And here is Annabelle at the fifth.
It's all very impressive. She's got a great swing. Tremendous future in front of her.
Back to the fourth. Long range eagle putt for Cope. Keep coming, keep coming. Yeah, pretty good in the end for distance. And that should be a fairly straightforward birdie. I'm sure there will be some mums and dads rather nervous.
Yeah, I think it's probably a little harder watching than it is playing in a lot of these circumstances.
For sure. Nice lag putt from Annabelle. Five par threes here at Nisles on the championship course, as well as five par fives as well.
It's an interesting mix for not a very long golf course to have five fives and five threes. Chance for some low scoring.
And that is a birdie for Jack Cope, so he gets to 4 under, and within 4 of our leader, Michael Gilbert. It's actually a little more on this than I first thought for Annabelle, but no problem at all.
Yeah, very confident young lady, happy with her stroke and rolls it in. There is a bit of breeze about today, as we can see the trees rustling, but not causing too much trouble to any of these players so far.
Gilbert's 2nd to 4 now. Can he reach this par 5 in 2? I think he likes it.
And he certainly should. That's 2 tremendous whacks to get it on the front edge. Long eagle putt, but on the putting surface.
And it was bang on line as well, Gary, wasn't it? Right down the flag.
Well, you can't beat a bit of good straight hitting.
And if you're long as well, that certainly helps. Birdie putt here for Jack Cope. Oh.
He's always just a little bit on the low side with that bit of break. He's cross with himself.
Back to number 4. And Gilbert, can he make the eagle? Outside chance. I'm sure he'd settle for a birdie.
Yep, with it all fairly tight at the top, a birdie will be good.
Oh, would he?
Look at that. That was never anywhere else, was it?
Very easy, this game, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Well, came up very nonchalantly there. Look at his face. Oh, knock him in like that all the time. What's the fuss?
Excellent stuff.
They really are. They're firing them in from everywhere, peppering the flags.
Connor Richards. Birdie opportunity for him. Playing with Michael Gilbert. Well done. 5 under. He'll be feeling he's playing okay, but at the moment, Gilbert is setting quite a pace at the front.
Yeah, Goddard now with his birdie attempt, and very good.
Back to level par. Christian Donaldson giving chase to Michael Gilbert. In the chasing pack anyway. Nice touch from him. And he made a birdie at the 4th hole to stay in touch. However, Gilbert setting some pace. 10 under par. There's some separation at the top there. 4 shots clear of Donaldson. As we continue the story of the Sir Henry Cooper Junior Masters 2016. Nice one, boys. The Sir Henry Cooper Junior Masters, in association with Centrip, first played back in 1998. It's grown and grown throughout the years to become a leading junior golf tournament in Europe. Lots of functions throughout the week and lots of money raised for charities as well, both for the Teenage Cancer Trust and for the Sir Henry Cooper Junior Masters Charitable Trust as well. And lots of bursaries given away to young golfers with promise, including last year's champion, Marco Penge.
I kind of wish I was playing, and I love this golf course and I love the place, so it'd be great if I could have played, but unfortunately I was elsewhere and had other things to play in, so yeah, it's just great to be back here and be around everyone. The support that they've given me and the money that they've helped me with to fund my golf going through the Golf Union means a lot, and I wouldn't be able to do it without them, really.
Back out on the course, and a bogey for Connor Richards at the 6th hole as the players start to struggle in the middle part of the course, so he goes back to 4 under par. A bogey at the 6th hole as well for Callum Farr. He goes back to 3 under. Now Donaldson birdied the 6th hole, but he gave it straight back at the 7th. He returns to 6 under par. So Michael Gilbert still 4 clear at the top. And he could be tough to catch. Now here is Charlie Strickland, who plays his golf at Ham Manor Golf Club. He's a big lad.
Lovely looking swing at this par 3 as well, and another good shot.
Very tidy indeed. Also giving chase, this is Harry Gillespie, 69 in the third round this morning. But good to hear from Marco Penge, Gary. It's important at this stage of a golfer's career, if you can get some money to keep you going. There's a lot of travelling involved these days.
There is. The amateurs play big circuits now, and quite honestly, back in the day, it was very difficult for a lot of these young players, unless they had very wealthy parents and things like that. And it kind of added to that elitist nature that people think. And of course, it's a great disappointment if some of these very talented players are deprived from playing because they don't have enough money. And this is where the bursaries really do help enormously.
Nicely rolled there from Charlie Strickland. He goes to 4 under after that birdie. Back to Gillespie at the second hole to get to -5.
Yeah, very good. Nice birdie, -5. Harry Gillespie moving in the right direction. As we take a look at Louisa Brunt on the 17th hole, another one of these very talented young girls, and from the squad, all inspired by victory in the Curtis Cup. Great old amateur event for ladies, and they are given great inspiration by watching those players to move forward.
Here's our leader in the boys' competition, Michael Gilbert, playing his third shot to the par 5, 10th. Nicely controlled. Says his golfing hero is Ernie Els. He met him as a youngster. What a thrill that must have been.
I think it's always a great thrill for these players if they have the opportunity to meet and talk to a great star. Wonderful for them.
Trouble here for Christian Donaldson. That's his fourth shot at the 9th hole.
Bit of trouble off the tee there he had as we move across to Annabelle Fuller on the 17th with her second shot.
She's just bogeyed the 16th, a rare slip.
Still playing very tidily though. She's managed herself extremely well over these last two rounds.
Yeah, that was normal service resumed, wasn't it? So to Strickland, par putt at the 10th. Oh, well done. Look what it means to him as well. He's got the mini fist pump going.
They've rolled in some beautiful mid to short length putts. They've been really good as we look to see can Annabelle make her putt. Up a bit quickly there. I think she realised the moment she'd hit that one, she hadn't quite struck it right out of the middle. But it's going to be a par.
And it's going to be a very handsome victory for Annabelle Fuller as well.
Now back to the 9th hole. This is sadly for a triple bogey.
Yeah, and that's a real body blow for Christian Donaldson, who slides all the way back to 4 under. 6 behind this man, who's facing another birdie putt. Oh, up and out of it quickly.
Once you get to the business end, the nerves kick in.
Well, we mentioned a couple of charities benefit from this week. One of them is the Teenage Cancer Trust. Let's find out more about their work.
Adrian Whiteson is the ex-boxing border control doctor. And he and his wife, Myrna, both noticed that there was a real gap in the medical area for teenagers. You know, it was either you had to be Great Ormond Street, you know, a young baby, or a terminally ill old man, and there was no space for teenagers.
What Teenage Cancer Trust does is build specialist Teenage Cancer Trust units in NHS hospitals so that these young people can be treated together alongside one another, and they're given specialist expert care by teenage cancer experts who understand what their needs are. the young people taking part in the tournament, the supporters, the volunteers, everybody involved this weekend, they're all playing a key role in helping Teenage Cancer Trust to take one step closer towards achieving our goal of reaching every single young person who needs our help and support.
Yeah, real feel-good factor this week. And well done to the people who are involved in the Teenage Cancer Trust. Now, back to the action, and this is Annabelle Fuller.
Yeah, a second shot on the 18th, on this very undulating, big roly green. And she's got an interesting putt coming up there, up and over the hump in the green.
To Callum Farr, who plays at Priors Hall Golf Club.
Third shot on this par 5, and a very nice shot it is. Should give him a good chance of a birdie.
And I can tell you he did go ahead and pop that one in to Harry Gillespie at the par 5 fourth hole. It's his 13th. He started at the 10th tee in this final round.
And a very good shot indeed. A bit unlucky it didn't check up. Nice swing there, you could see as he was really punching down in, chopped off the follow through to try and get a little bit more spin. Didn't quite happen though for him.
To the 18th, and our champion elect from the girls section, Annabelle Fuller. Outside chance of a birdie. Well, perhaps the enormity of what she's about to achieve is beginning to hit home over the last couple of holes for her.
As we cross to our leader, Michael Gilbert, with his putt running nicely at the hole.
Yeah, a little bit slower. That might have dropped in to the par 3 11th hole, 160 yards. This is Nathan Longley.
Good contact. It sounded a really crisp. You could see ball divot.
They're generating a lot of spin, aren't
they? They are, really. Tremendous action.
Now, come on, Annabelle, let's finish it off with a par. Oh, well, she gave it a good roll. In fact, she's rolled it about 3 feet past.
So, having watched Longley's ball spin back, here he is with his long birdie attempt. And a great putt. Very, very good. Minus two.
17 years of age. Started playing age 10 after watching golf on TV like so many others. To Gillespie.
They're going in from all over the place. That's a wonderful putt from Harry Gillespie.
Heck of an up and down.
It was, yeah. Goes to minus six.
And across to the 18th once again, and surely the last putt today for Annabelle Fuller, who is the Sir Henry Cooper Junior Masters champion for the girls section for 2016. And well done, Annabelle, a thumping victory. Biggest win of her junior golfing career to date, no doubt about it.
Now, our leader there, Michael Gilbert, but that was for a bogey, and so he has gone back to 9 under.
Yes, and all of a sudden at the top there, he was 5 ahead, remember, a short while ago. It's getting a bit tighter, currently leading by 3. There is Sister Sam giving Annabelle a big hug. Well played. Yeah, that's her dad as well. So she's the girls' champion. Who is going to win it for the boys? Michael Gilbert currently 3 ahead of Jack Cope and Harry Gillespie.
I think it's Jordan Spieth.
Jordan Spieth.
Tiger Woods.
Got Tiger Woods.
Because he changed the game.
Rory McIlroy, because he's from Northern Ireland.
Probably Jordan Spieth, you know, the way he conducts himself.
TPC Sawgrass, great boss.
I'd probably say Royal Birkdale.
Pinehurst is good. Don't know why, I just would like to play there.
Actually, I think it's my home course in Nidavellen in Switzerland.
Probably Lewis Hamilton, who gets to drive that car really fast.
David Beckham.
Anthony Joshua.
Conor McGregor, the UFC fighter, he's just good crack.
Jamie Vardy.
I just saw it on TV and wanted to start, really. Everyone asked me and to find it really weird that I've got no family who play golf, but I just saw it and wanted to, you know, I was really into football, but when I saw golf, I wanted to give it a try.
My parents play golf since, I don't know when, like since I'm born. So they just took me to a golf course once and I liked it from the beginning.
I'd love to play a tour event or get the tour card for a year.
PGA Tour player, ideally.
Have a good, successful amateur career and to turn pro and hopefully play on the European Tour.
2 times the Swiss Championship.
Winning West Surrey Players Tour.
Playing for Ireland under 18s before my 16th birthday.
Winning under 16s last year.
Either Conor McGregor or Mike Tyson.
Scarlett Johansson.
Whitney Houston.
Barack Obama would be quite cool.
Well, we know who the girls' champion is. We're waiting to find out who will win the boys' section of this year's Sir Henry Cooper Junior Masters in association with Centrip and Gary Ellis. The standard of golf has been pretty good over the last few days.
I've been very impressed. I think there have been some wonderful swingers and some great shots played. And indeed, we're seeing some future champions, as indeed there have been champions coming from this event who've won on the European Tour.
Nice one from Conor Richards there, who plays his golf at Shanklin and Sandown over on the Isle of Wight.
Now, Harry Gillespie's tee shot on the 8th hole. 6 under par. And another wonderful shot there, giving a chance of a birdie.
Yeah, remember, he's playing the course round the other way, so that's his 17th. This is Charlie Strickland. Hello. Oh, what a shot.
It was fantastic. A beautiful long swing, delicate, slow sliding the club under the ball. Wonderful.
That definitely had a touch of the Ernie Els's about it. Now, Gillespie for birdie to get to 7 under within 2 of the lead.
Oh.
Never quite had it online, did he, really?
No, it was always a little bit low and slightly lacking in pace to hold the line. Now, Conor Richards, his eagle putt. Just swings away from the hole, but close enough for a tap-in birdie.
Time for us to find out a little bit more about the bursaries that are awarded by this organisation.
There's a lot of amateur golfers, elite junior amateur golfers, that need financial assistance, but not just financial assistance, a life education. And our charity affiliation with the Teenage Cancer Trust provides the perfect illustration of adversity. So not only are we giving them financial support, but we're giving them that important life education for them to go forward. So it's about supporting not just the golfer, but the individual.
And that's the wonderful thing about golf, of course, is that it is a family and it does help to develop individuals. Back to the action. Donaldson, third shot out of the sand at 15.
Oh, it's fantastic. There's been wonderful bunker shots and that really just caps it all. I mean, it was a difficult shot there off the upslope and beautifully controlled.
Yeah, Charlie Strickland came close, but Christian Donaldson has got it. Now, trouble here for Strickland. Oh, stop it. That's outrageous. 5 under. He's enjoying himself out there, and why not?
Yeah, you could see that meant everything to him as we go across to Jack Cope with his second shot at the 18th from the light rough.
I don't think we'll be seeing a lot of spin on this one, no. Through the back. Ooh. Just for a moment, thought it might roll its way back down the bank.
Bit of green to work with there, though, so chance to get it up and down.
So to our leader, Michael Gilbert, second to 17.
You One of the good things of this Nisles golf course in challenge is the fact that the greens are like upturned bowls, and so often the ball, if it pitches near the edge, will just roll off, Dominic.
Tricky starts here, Gary.
Yeah, that's a tough shot there to keep still. He'd take a nice wide base and got a good contact on it, and a four-footer to save the par.
Now to Charlie Strickland, playing his second at 17, remember, coming off two birdies in a row. Can he get it in close? Can he find another one? Oh, he may well do. He's got the wind in his sails.
Yes, he certainly has there, as we go across to Jack Cope on the 18th.
That is a lovely round of golf. A 69 in the final round for Jack Cope. So he gets in at 6 under par. May well be good enough for second place.
And Michael Gilbert from the edge of the green, his birdie putt. Running well.
Ooh, go on though. Now, the camera angle always foreshortens it. I wouldn't be surprised if that's 10 feet away. Well, Jack Cope got in at 6 under par, and Harry Gillespie finished on that mark as well, tied for second place after a closing 70.
Strickland's birdie putt on the 17th. Six under.
Big putt upcoming for Michael Gilbert. This one's for par. Just a fraction too much pace. He's lipped out a couple of times today, so he's going to drop a shot there. Back to eight under, but he will take a two-shot lead up the last.
Some of the young talent that, you know, was kicking around the course today, was pretty impressive. And I know obviously past players that have played here, you know, the likes of Chris Wood, Justin Rose, etc., you know, really proves that today is a vital day for the young guns to go and make a name for themselves on the junior tour.
Well done to Harvey Byers there in the retro cap, who climbed into the top 10. On the back of a closing 69, Gilbert, second shot into the 18th. He's nearly there.
Yes, one last good straight hit should see him over the line.
Nicely controlled, gripping down on the club.
Yeah, he's managed his game very, very well, the young fella. It's a delight to see. Very easy when you're young teenager to be too willowy, which often happens, but he's really solid. Good game, well coached, and I see a lot of him.
Plenty crowded around this 18th green to see the champion home. Couple of putts will do very nicely, thank you. Up a big tier. Sit down.
Well, it's a little bit more than he'd want, but he's held out very well, hasn't he, Dominic? So I'm fully expecting him to knock it in.
Well, the group out behind them have played well today and this week, but they will not catch Michael Gilbert. And he does knock it in. Well done. Excellent week for Michael Gilbert, and he is the 2016 Sir Henry Cooper Junior Masters champion. Closing 71, good enough to do it for Michael, who wins by two in the end from Jack Cope and Harry Gillespie. Charlie Strickland bogeyed the last to finish at 5 under alongside Connor Richards. Well done to Annabelle Fuller, our girls champion, celebrated her victory with sister Sam, a big influence in her life.
Having my sister there has been like helped me always, because I've always strived to be as good as her, and like she hasn't won this tournament yet, so it's quite fun to see now that maybe she could win it, because she still has another year to do it as well, so it'll be fun next year.
And I wonder if Michael Gilbert will return. He's only 15 years of age, and he is our boys' champion.
It's so amazing because, I mean, I've got a couple of years left, so I've won this quite early, and to be along the names of European Tour players now and winners is just great.
There they are, our two champions, and well done to everyone who took part this year in the Sir Henry Cooper Junior Masters.